Ahoy there, YouTube! I'm back here today for another game review. Today I'm very excited to check out Word-A-Melon from Bananagrams. This is for 2 to 4 players, ages 6 plus. It'll take about, 10, 15 minutes to play. And in Word-A-Melon, you are going to be trying to flip over letters in order to spell words. You're going to be rolling a die, you're going to be flipping over letters, and you're going to try to spell words, because if you're able to spell words, you will get to keep those letters. Whoever has the most letters at the end of the game win. It's very light, it's very simple, it's shaped like a watermelon, but is it good? Let's open it up, and I'll tell you what I think. Alrighty then, we're going to take a look at what you're going to get inside of Word-A-Melon. So first of all, we have your handy dandy rule book. It's one half of a watermelon, double-sided full color, single-sided full color. And it's very well done. It should have you up and running in no time at all. It's also a very simple game, so I can teach you how to play right now. So before I get started, I want to mention that I have 4 letters off to the side. Normally you're supposed to set out the more difficult letters or some of the more easy letters. I just randomly set out 4. But they do give you extra letters if you want a trickier or an easier game, which is nice as well. So in Word-A-Melon, you are going to be rolling this dice right here, which will either have the number 5, 4, or 3 on there. And that's how many letters you are going to get to flip over like so. Once you've flipped over these letters, you are going to try to spell a word. That's a pretty poor start. If you're able to spell a word, so let's just cheat, pick this one as well. If you're able to spell a word, then you get to keep those letters, and those letters are victory points for the end of the game. So let's just say I went first, I rolled a 4, I flipped over these 4, and I said, I'm gonna go with us, because that's the best thing I think I can spell, which means I keep these, that's worth 2 victory points for me at the end of the game. These get flipped back over, but not before everybody takes note of where they are, because there is a memory aspect to this game. So now let's just say that the next person had, they had OG. So they had OG and they had 3, and they went, wait, I remember, there was a D right here, and, there was a D right there. So now they would be able to spell dog, which means they could boom, 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 pick up all 3 of these and have successfully created a 3-letter word. Next person rolls. Let's just see what we get. We get a 3. So let's flip over 3. We got an A, we got an S, and we got an I. So we might go with is. So boom, 2-letter word, flip that back over. That's a very valuable letter, so most likely someone's going to try and remember where that A is. And you're going to continue to do this until you get to the point where no one can spell anything. And how you do that is eventually you'll just flip over all of them. So you'll have like 3, 4, 5 of them left over. You'll just flip over all of them, and you'll all agree that no one else can spell anything. At which point, you will then tally up how many of these chips you have. Whoever has the most chips will be the winner of the game, and that, in a nutshell, is how you're going to play Word-A-Melon. Alrighty then, Word-A-Melon from Bananagrams. What are my final thoughts? Let's go to the pros, let's go to the cons. First, on the con side, game's not going to be for everybody for a variety of different reasons. First and foremost, 2 to 4 players, restricted player count. Also, it's incredibly light, it's an incredibly simple game. It's for ages 6+, and I would say this is definitely going to hit the family weight market more than the filler weight market. This is definitely something I will not bring out on game nights. It's primarily when I'm playing games with kids and I want them to work on their spelling. And in that ilk, it's more of an educational tool. Well, it definitely is a game. I don't want to shortchange the fact that this is a game. This is a little bit of an educational tool as well, which might be turned off to some people. Another comment I have of the game is that flipping over 3 letters versus flipping over 5 letters is huge. So there's a lot of luck of the dice here. If a kid continuously is rolling 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5 while you get 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, then most likely they are going to win the game. And that's just the nature of the beast. So there's definitely a lot of luck in this game. Any other cons I have of the game? Oh, sometimes you'll just flip over letters and you just won't get any vowels and you're just like, well, looks like I'm hosed. And that's just the nature of the game. There's nothing you can do about that. Now, that it can be offset though, so I want you to take that with a grain of salt because you're supposed to remember where the vowels are because there's a memory aspect to this game, which is another con. If you don't like spelling games, or you don't like memory games, well, then this has both of them, so obviously you're going to want to steer clear of this. So it's very light, it's very simple, I mean, you really need to know that going into the game, that this is primarily aimed at a family crowd and at a children's game crowd. But if you can get past that, I enjoyed Word-A-Melon for what it is. And this is an attempt to help kids learn how to spell. It's fun. It's appealing. The kids were instantly intrigued by the fact that it's shaped like a watermelon, and the game itself is shaped like a watermelon, which is really kind of cool. All the components are very nice. I really like how the letters work, how you can kind of flip them over. I like the fact that there's a couple different variants. I think there's 2 variants in there. We tried both of them, and I liked both of them, especially the one that had like a Texas Hold'em style, community pool where you can always use these letters over here because that will speed up the game, which is great, and also will make it easier for people to spell words, which for kids is very useful as well. So I like the components. I like the aesthetic appeal of the game. I like the fact that this is a teaching game. I really like the fact that it comes in a watermelon zip pouch, which is really stinking cool. That's another con. Some people are absolutely not going to like the packaging of this game. I think it's unique. I think it's creative. I think it's going to attract kids to play this game, which is what I want out of this game. So, in the end, I like Word-A-Melon. I think it's a really neat game. I think it's reinventing the wheel. It's like spectacular or fantastic. No. But as a teacher and as someone who has two kids and eventually those kids are going to have to learn how to spell, I think this is a fantastic game to get to help them learn how to spell. And also as a teacher, I think this is a fantastic game to have in your classroom. I definitely think this is the kind of thing that you could set out if you had, say, first, second, or third graders where they could play it by themselves and work on it. Because this is definitely, it's a family game, but at the same time, with kids, I definitely think this could be a children's game where children could just play this by themselves once they know what they're doing because it's very simple, very straightforward. So in the end, Word-A-Melon. If you have kids or if you work with kids that are on the younger side and need to work on their spelling, I think this is an absolutely fantastic game to get. If not, it's a very easy pass. So that's Word-A-Melon. If you enjoyed this review, please be sure to click on that subscribe button down below in the comments below. Let me know, watermelon, yay or nay? For me personally, oh yeah, big yay. I love watermelon, but more importantly, I love watermelon flavoring. Oh yeah, popsicles, watermelon's a choice. That's the one I'm always going to get. But let me know in the comments below, watermelon, yay or nay? And as always, thanks for your time, YouTube.